Hi everyone, and welcome to a new video where I would like to show you another old recording. Today we're going to explore a bit more of chamber music constellation, even though some people will laugh because when I will say Heifetz, yes, we did a video about Heifetz one time and I don't think it will be the last one. Then there is also Piatigorsky in the recording and Mr. Primrose, William Primrose. The video today is going to be mainly about few elements that we neglect somehow in our approach to music today. It is less is more. So, less is more means natural, simple phrasing, as simple as possible, which would come straight to the audience as something which they could also do. Phrase like this, simple and easy. The second thing that I would like to focus on will be actually the pulse. And I did already one video about the pulse that I encourage you to watch again, but I will be talking about the pulse now one more time. And the third element which will come out of the simplicity of the pulse is the ability to make music together. Chamber music, in that case, three people. It can be two people, can be four, five, etc., etc. In a way we would call music making in an orchestra, like also ultimate chamber music, because all the people have to play together. So that is going to be the third element that we're going to focus on as a result of number one and number two. I might allow myself to comment a little bit while the recording is going to be played, because, well, I will present to you the finale of the Divertimento in E-flat major from Mozart for violin, viola and cello. So because it's a rondo, obviously the theme will repeat many times. Why do I choose this piece actually to speak about those notions is because those three incredible virtuosos, which were Heifetz, Primrose and Piatigorsky, they all kind of managed to get down to this simplicity level, to this enjoyment of playing music together and just making the greatest Mozart, one of the most famous actually string trio existing, the Divertimento of Mozart. They managed to make it sound like it's piece of cake. Let's listen to that together, and then I might show you a little bit, or I might stop the recording, or I might just simply talk over it. Enjoy. And just before we continue, I will just add one little thing that you have to pay attention on more than anything else. If you're a violinist, pay attention, obviously, on how easy and how simple is Heifetz's approach of this very, very, very simple, almost pop theme. If you're a viola player, please pay attention on how incredibly precise and yet musical William Primrose is playing his accompanying part. And if you're a cellist, and as a matter of fact, we discovered this recording and we listened to it with a good friend and colleague of mine when we played this piece for the last time, Alexei Stadler, who you might heard of, obviously, we noticed how present, beautiful, noble, and actually excellent the bass line is played by Piatigorsky. It's pretty impressive when you have mainly tonica dominant or sometimes subdominant and then tonica again. To play, to have such a ground, to give such a base to the whole polyphonic writing of Mozart like this is pretty incredible. So, one more time. Different this time. Pulse. Simple. Thank you. So, after a recording like that, I don't know how one could express better what is a simple, natural way to phrase, what is a inner pulse, and chamber musician, chamber music playing, let's say, between those three guys. We talked about natural phrasing, and you obviously heard it. I mean, in such a genius, easy, simple, plain music from Mozart, it's rather evident that one should just feel the meaning of a tonica, a subdominante, a dominante, and back to the tonica. This is extremely important. This is, I would call it the basics of music making, to feel the harmony on the simplest way. Once I remember I had the amazing chance to have a masterclass with Daniel Barenboim in Kronberg Academy, where he would talk to all of us, all the students and postgraduates of the Kronberg Academy, where he basically told us one of the greatest keys to music is harmony. Although we think always melody and we think rhythm and stuff, but here is harmony. And it is true that this is one of the greatest key, because harmony gives you the feel, gives you the color, gives you the understanding of what you're doing. And when you're making chamber music, when you're playing chamber music, it is an absolute must to understand what is the harmony that is being used in the moment when you're playing. How is the harmony evolving? Where is the harmony going? Where are the tensions? Where are the releases? And sometimes it doesn't depend on you. And now I'm mostly talking to violinists, because we are not the ones who are making the harmony change. We are the ones who are very often reacting on the harmony change. But in order to understand how to react on the harmony change, we have to explore the parts of our colleagues and the scores in order to understand how does the harmony change, in which direction does harmony change, and what is the meaning of this harmony change, and then discuss this, or not discuss, just reacting naturally and simply on the harmony change with our colleagues. In this recording, actually in the whole divertimento, I would like you to pay attention on how does the music, the chamber music making, happen between those three giants, whereas it's the viola which directs the harmony change, or the cello, and the way Heifetz reacts to this. This is simply a delight. This is so simple, so obvious, makes total sense, and it's just warm to listen to, because we realize, my God, yes, obviously, in this direction, it makes sense. I would like to play this piece, because I would like to try to do the same, because it seems so easy, so elegant, and so simple. What is the main difficulty in combining all these elements? Obviously, it's that to play simple and elegant, that it would remind you like you would sing along a melody because you just want to sing for fun. That is how you should actually sound. That's how you should play, so that the people who come out of your concert or of your performance, they sing exactly like that. They will not play your instrument, they will just sing. So you have to be able to play like this. You have to be able to feel a permanent pulse that will give this natural groove, to use another word to the pulse, and to be able to play together as those guys did, to combine all those notions and to know the basically the harmonies also through which you're going, so that you know in which kind of simplicity direction are you going. What is hard about all of this is that all of that requires some practice. And the practice is not just playing the notes and just learning them in the best way for intonation or sound. It's not only that. It's also to be a little bit more interested by other aspects of the instrument playing, like to come down with the difficulty of the practicing, to come down to the simplicity of the music behind it, which sometimes is much more simple than one thinks because of all our technical problems. And then to be able to fold all of this into a regular, beautiful, simple pulse. And once we have that, then we have a chance to meet with wonderful colleagues, to just sit and play. And when you realize that your colleagues are giving you harmonies or helping you out with harmonies as much as you would like to, then you're on clouds. If you feel that there might be something to maybe change or to make more accurate as a change of harmony or as a following aspect of this phrasing, let's say, you can always discuss that. For us violinists, it also comes to the moment when we have to accompany, and this is also a moment when we have to be simple, when we have to follow the natural harmonies, and we have to stay with the correct pulse so that we help our colleagues. Chamber music is very, very, very important nowadays in order to understand how to combine all those elements, because in the very end, even for soloists, for people who are more into the solo aspect of the career, you must understand that you're going to make chamber music with the conductor, you're going to make chamber music with the orchestra, and even when you play alone, you're in a way making chamber music with the audience. So I hope you enjoyed this recording of Heifetz, Piatigorsky and Primrose as much as I did. I listen usually to the whole piece, obviously, but now I just wanted to share this simple and nice finale with you. Remember well, simplicity, less is more. Pulse, always, pulse, pulse, pulse. And three, when you are playing with other musicians, chamber music, respect, hearing, harmonies, reacting, same energies, same endeavor, same love to the music and respect. Yeah? Three things for today. I wish you all the best and I will think about the next video to share with you. Bye.